event is one.
The creme de la creme in the legal profession in the country are those gathered here.
Thank you, Mr. Vice President.
Prominent among them is Nigeria's Vice President, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, who has joined to celebrate a senior advocate of Nigeria, Chief Wole Olanipekun, as he clocks 70.
Many years ago, I said to Chief Olanipekun that he is becoming Nigeria's most consequential constitutional lawyer, given the number and variety of the major cases that he has been in, and many of which he has won. He is probably one of the most consequential and influential lawyers in the Commonwealth.
In the midst of the celebrations, the second edition of the WOC Justice Summit is holding. And this time, experts are dissecting the issue of justice sector reforms.
Professor Olanrewaju Fagbohun, S.A.N.
First to take the podium on the subject is the keynote speaker, who identifies 9 gaps in the judicial system. He believes there should be consequences for filing of frivolous applications, and the Supreme Court can determine a shift in reforms.
They have a process at the National Industrial Court where your judgment, you get them electronically. Where when you have paid for service, your papers, the processes will be served without you having to stress yourself or suffer through anything. It is the mindset of the individuals who are carrying out activities out. And we need to come back to train them.
Next is the need for training judicial officers, which may help entrench integrity in appointments.
So long as the judicial system, particularly the judiciary, is perceived as being devoid of integrity, then it's equally bad.
If you want to set the state on fire,
then there is the need to put merit above political influence for judicial appointees.
If we are going to make progress, we must have a system that is transparent and not a situation where the governors will tell the chief judges, these are my candidates.
For the matriarch of the bar, the celebrant is one person who is not unperturbed about the nation's governance.
So concerned about our current turbulent times and has advocated for a new constitution altogether to replace the 1999 constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, under which we pretend to have a federal system of government when in fact we have a unitary system of government.
And to put final thoughts to the topic, the celebrant believes the Supreme Court should attract the best brains in the sector, and Nigeria will need a judicial sector Marshall Plan.
For justice reform, we need a Magna Carta. Nigeria needs a Magna Carta. And before we can get to the Magna Carta, we need a Marshall Plan.
The event cannot end without a word from the celebrant's pillar of many years.
To my husband, I bless God again for the day God brought us together. You're such a phenomenal friend and husband to me. I love you and I will always love you to the moon and back.
For many stakeholders here, solutions have been articulated and they expect that the much-needed implementation to ensure speedy justice delivery will follow.